Cuquet, suppose that you were down in the city of Mexico, and you're lost.
And what?
And you're lost.
I'm lost.
Mm-hmm. And you go up to a policeman, and he asks you, ¿Dónde vive usted? Now, what would you say to him?
He's asked me where I live, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'd tell him? I'd say, Mr. Officer, I'm a poor little lost kitty cat. You take me to the station house and just give me a great big ice cream cone, and I'll tell you where I live over there, feller.
Well, while Cool Cat is trying to find out where he lives, that's what the lesson's going to be about today.
Where we
is,
live.
¿Dónde vive usted? Where do you live?
No ice cream cone.
Well, amigos, are you ready for the Yo Repito part of our program? Remember, the key action word is ¿Dónde vive usted? ¿Dónde vive usted? Yo vivo en la ciudad. Well, let's turn to our viewer's guide and see some of our cartoons. In our first cartoon, that we are on the street, and I ask the señorita, I ask her, ¿Dónde vive usted? ¿Dónde vive usted? Repitan, amigos, ¿Dónde vive usted? Where do you live? She answers, Yo vivo en esta ciudad. Yo vivo en esta ciudad. I live in this city. Repitan, amigos, Yo vivo en esta ciudad. I live in this city. En esta ciudad. Muy bien. Another natural question that I would ask her is, ¿Es usted americana? ¿Es usted americana? Are you American? ¿Es usted americana? No. No. Yo soy mexicana. Yo soy mexicana. Repitan, amigos. Yo soy mexicana. Mexicana. Now, the next is an expression that you'll ask, I would think, many times. You'll hear it. You'll hear it or you'll ask it yourself. Do you speak English? ¿Habla usted inglés? ¿Habla usted inglés? ¿Habla usted inglés? The answer, no, I only speak Spanish. No. Yo hablo solamente español. No, yo hablo solamente español. Now, remember what I told you. Try to speak Spanish when you get down to Mexico, south of the border, Spanish-speaking countries. Even if you make mistakes, you are honoring the people. They love you to try to speak their language, which they love very much, and they should. And they'll love to help you. No, hablo solamente español. Hablo solamente español. Well, we're asking for instructions. We want to take a bus. ¿Dónde para el autobús? ¿Dónde para el autobús? Repitan, amigos. ¿Dónde para el autobús? It stops here. And there's that parada that I thought Cool Cat was going to say it was a parade. Para aquí. It stops here. Para aquí. The bus stop. Para aquí. Where is the bus stop? Para aquí. Para aquí. It stops here. Muy bien. Let's go to the museum. I express to Cool Cat, I say, Vámonos al museo. Vámonos al museo. Vámonos al museo. I love that word, vámonos. Let's go. Vámonos al museo. It's a wonderful idea. Es una idea magnífica. Es una idea magnífica. You didn't know, did you, that magnificent in Spanish, you know, it sounds so good as that, huh? Magnífica. Just makes it such a good word. And es una idea magnífica. Okay. Now, we do go to the museum. El Museo de Antropología. El Museo de Antropología. And, as we see here, the guide asks us, ¿En qué país viven ustedes? ¿En qué país viven? There's the plural. ¿En qué país viven ustedes? In what country do you live? ¿En qué país viven ustedes? Now, I thought I'd throw it in this lesson. This is the first time you've seen the United States in Spanish. We live in the United States. Vivimos en los Estados Unidos. Repitan, amigos. Vivimos en los Estados Unidos. We live in the United States. Los Estados Unidos. The United States. Nice, long word. Sounds good in Spanish, doesn't it? Los Estados Unidos. I could have said in America, but you know, America is a lot of America. Sudamerica, Norte America, America Central. So America wouldn't be as specific as Los Estados Unidos. Vivimos. Okay, I live, yo vivo. You live, usted vive. We live, nosotros vivimos. you or they, plural, live? Ellos viven, ustedes viven, viven. All right. We are at the Museo de Antropología, and I asked the guide, is it closed today? ¿Está cerrado hoy? ¿Está cerrado hoy? ¿Está cerrado hoy? You've seen that cerrado before. Well, the opposite, it's open. Temporary state of condition, right? No, está abierto. No, está abierto. It is open. Cerrado, abierto. Closed, open. No, está abierto. Okay. How much does it cost to enter? ¿Cuánto es la entrada? ¿Cuánto es la entrada? How much is the entrance fee? ¿Cuánto es la entrada? At this particular museum that, well, the girl says anyway, la entrada es gratuita. Let's not change anything. You might change your mind. La entrada es gratuita. It's absolutely free. La entrada es gratuita. Okay? Repitan, amigos. La entrada es gratuita. And the final cartoon that we do have here is, we see a cool cat. I don't blame him. But I like that expression. Can one take pictures? Can one take pictures? ¿Se permite sacar fotos? Isn't that a nice expression? ¿Se permite sacar fotos? May one take pictures? ¿Se permite sacar fotos? No se permite. No se permite. It is not permitted. It is not allowed. No se permite. Generally, they do not let you take pictures inside the museum, but they, as I mentioned before, they do have very, very nice and very reasonable prices. They have very nice slides and pictures of various things in the museum, much better than you could take inside with the lighting conditions as they are inside the museum. Muy bien, amigos. Those are the expressions in the Yo Repito part. Time to relax for the Yo Escucho, the I Listen part of our program.
Today, I'm going to sing a song which in Mexico we sing at birthdays. Usually, it's sung just before the person whose birthday it is wakes up. And it's called Las Mañanitas. Estas son las mañanitas que cantaba el rey David. A las muchachas bonitas se las cantamos así. Despierta, mi bien, despierta, mira que ya amaneció. Y a los pajarillos cantan, la luna ya se metió. Qué linda está la mañana en que vengo a saludarte. Venimos todos con gusto y placer a felicitarte. Ya viene amaneciendo y a la luz del día nos dio. Levántate de mañana.